Hey everyone, Larry Snow here with another video. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how I was able to create a child theme, a very, very simple child theme, in order to add social media icons to a WordPress header. And in this case, the 2012 WordPress theme. And the reason why I did that was because over the last couple of years, I've had a lot of views on the two tutorials I did to add how to add social media icons to your WordPress header. And up front, forgive me, my voice, I have a little froggy in there, so I apologize. But hopefully you can hear me okay. So I've helped a couple of dozen people personally. They've come to me and said, I don't know how to do this, it's not working for my theme, and they've been from all walks of life. They've been solopreneurs, entrepreneurs, they've been nonprofits, they've been just individuals, they've been a whole host of different folks who are just basically looking for help on how to add social media icons for their particular theme. And in one or two instances, people have actually said, hey, you know, why don't you create a child theme? Or I don't know how to do the HTML on this, so can you make it any easier for us? So I said, well, I didn't have enough time at the moment. I'd say I'd take a look into it. Since I've been a little under the weather, I thought I'd just take a quick look at this to see if it was an easy thing to do. And it turns out it's kind of easy, at least the initial part, and that's where I'm at now. And I'll show you what I've done. There is a download for the child theme that I created, which will include a starter set of icons. At least it will be linking to my website. And my goal is that you would remove those links or replace them with your own icons from your own media library. And we'll get into that in a minute. But basically what you're looking at is the child theme. And this is the 2012, exclusively for the 2012 theme, as that's the only one I've tested it for. And let's get into the nuts and bolts of this. So to start off with, what I did was I used the 2012 theme, copied the entire folder of the 2012 theme, and deleted everything I didn't need, and renamed it 2012-child. Let's take a look at that. And in here, this is all I'm using. I didn't want to have all that other stuff. In fact, WordPress says only use the stuff you're going to change, because what happens with the functions is, in the functions, it's an addition to. So you remove all the stuff that you want to keep in the actual 2012 theme and only have in this functions in the 2012 child the functions that you're going to be adding. The header is replacing the header. And the screenshot is the one from the 2012 theme. And the styles is only the styles that I'm going to change with an import of what's coming in from the 2012 parent theme. So let's take a look at all that in the code. So to start off with, this is functions.php. And again, it's just the stuff I have added. And what I've added is I had to register a sidebar called social icons top. And I've called it social icons header. And this is the description. And the before widget, title, before title, after title thing is not necessarily for you to know, but basically what it does is it creates an on-the-fly type of ID and class widget. And it ends it with a class widget title and an H2. So the title, you can add something above the social icons, which I did not do. You can add in, you know, follow me, contact us, or something, if you want to put something up there. So that's simple enough. In the header, if you've been following or have watched my other two tutorials on how to add social media icons to your WordPress header. This will seem kind of familiar. It has div ID social icons top, declared the dynamic sidebar social icons top, very simple. And the styles are all right here in the style.css. So I'll get to the top in a minute, but this is all the formatting for the div, and this is all the formatting for the images that you would put in. I do have one other piece in here, and that was just to tighten the gap between the icons on the right and the text on the left. There's a space in between, and I wanted to narrow that gap, so that's in there as well. So the stuff at the top here, this, if you go to the Child Themes Codex from WordPress.org, this is mandatory information that you need to have, well, at least two pieces of it is. You need to have the theme name, and you need to have the template, because the template determines what parent theme it is. The other stuff is just fluff. You add in contact information, description of the theme, who the author is, and if you want to find out about me, and a version number if you so choose. The other important part in this is the import of the parent theme 2012 style. Because what I did not do was list all of the styles in the parent theme, because this is a child theme. So I've only added in the pieces that I'm going to use specific for that sidebar. Okay? Because that's the only thing that I'm changing from the theme. All right? So, with all that said, how do you get this thing to work? Well, it's currently running on my local server here. And to do that, you would go to Appearance, Themes, and here it is, 2012 Child. And all of this information that's in that that's in the style CSS, all of this information right here, this is all where it's located right here, all this information. But since I currently have it running, what I'll do to show you how to upload it, I will activate 2012. That will allow me to delete the child. Okay. Then I will go to install, upload, and mine is right here. And I will drag and drop and install. And if you notice here, it says the this theme requires a parent theme, checking if it is installed. And it's, so it's got to verify that you actually have the theme that you've been declared as the template. So it does verify that, so that's important to know. And it says it is, it's currently installed, and then it says that this theme is installed successfully. I just click Live Preview. You can save and activate. And if you go to the widgets, because this is what we created, here's our social icon header. And here is that description that was in functions. Let me just show you functions real quick. And everything's been updated locally here. So here's functions, here's that description right here. And here it is showing up right here on the right side. So this is now a sidebar type of thing, and with the name of social icons header. Now in it, you will find a pre-made code for you. Now, this is where I'm at. The next challenge for me is to figure out how to make this more helpful for you guys and just make it simple input fields. So you would input your URL for Google+, Twitter, blah, 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 all the way down, and then click Save, and then it would update, and all of that stuff would be pre-formatted and all look pretty pretty. But for now, what I've done is set you guys up with a pre-formatted type of text function that is still necessary for this thing to actually work. So these images are hosted on my website, and what I would ask you to do is go to your media library, add new, add up all your icons, switch out this link and put in the icon and then change the URL to point to where your account is, your profile, your handle is. And you can also copy this and then add in the next one and the next one and the next one, how many you want. If you make it too wide, it might wrap around with the icons. If it does, you go into the editor. And this is where all the code is, right? And you would say width, make that a little wider, please. And the icons would straighten out again. So this is available for you guys to try out. Again, I'm experimenting with it just as much as you are by using it. Give it a try. Let me know what you think. Let me know if I'm in the right area, if this is helpful, if it isn't helpful. And the link will be available. It is available right now. It's at larrysnow.me/childzip. It's free to use. I ask if just to give me feedback on it and let me know if it's something that this is worthwhile for you guys to do. Again, this is not a finished child theme in that I'd want to have more functionality for you guys to make it easier for you guys to input the icons in a more automated fashion rather than still doing it manually. But this does skip a step from using my previous two tutorials. It does skip a step. So anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks for continuing watching these WordPress tutorials. I really appreciate your feedback, your comments. I love helping people. So if you need help on this stuff, just post in the comments below and I'll help you out when I can and as much as I can. Thank you for the likes. Thank you for the subscribers. Thank you for the views. I really appreciate it. It helps me get motivated to make more of these. If you have a special thing that you want me to share on how to do, post in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video.